good carp fly is a simple fly. The thread I'm using for this is a Danville's 3-aught wax monocord, and the hook is a Gamagatsu SL45 in a size 6. I'm going to mount a 1/8 dazzle eye in the middle and on top of the hook shank. And bring the thread back to the rear end. Create a small dubbing loop. And then wind the thread forward. In this dubbing loop, I'm going to put some of the Whitlock's SLF dubbing. This is the dark olive for the Helgramite. Give it some good twist. And then wrap this forward. Creating the body of this fly. Do a figure eight around those dumbbells. And tie it off. Next, I'm going to select two pieces of marabou to lay on top as a wing. I like to wet these just so they're easier to control. The rotary vise, we can flip this fly completely upside down to lay in the marabou. One tuft of marabou on either side of the hook point. Next, I'm going to select a piece of this olive dyed Brahma hen hackle. Trim it to length. Attach it to the front. You give it about 2 or 3 wraps at the front, not much. I like to finish it up with some head cement, just to make it a more durable fly. A good carp fly has got to have some counterweight on it so that it flips the hook upside down or hook point up. You're going to be dragging it through some obstacles and some shallow water and mud. You gotta keep it out of the grass. Alright, so really quick here, seeing as how this is such a speedy fly to tie, I'm gonna tie up a second variation of this pattern. This time in the crayfish or rust orange. I use the same size hook, the SL45, and a size 6, and the same size dazzle eye or dumbbell eye. This time I'm going to go with a gold colored one instead of the black. This color variation is a more popular one although I tend to use the black more than anything else. This crayfish rust orange is definitely the best selling one. Dubbing I'm going to use on this is the same Whitlock's SLF, but this time in the red fox squirrel nymph abdomen color. And twist up the dubbing loop. Wrap it forward. Get it around those eyes. Tie it off. Flip it upside down again. With this one, I'm going to use a brown piece of utility saddle hackle. Because what I'm going to do is tie it in right at the butt, and I'm only going to wrap it maybe two or three times, just utilizing really thick webbing at the base of the feather. Great movement. Good brown color, too. Again, the more popular color.
Now remember, you can tie this backstabber carp fly in almost any color that you want. I tend to prefer the darker colors, the more drab colors, olives, browns, blacks. But you can tie it in whatever color marabou you can find. And you don't necessarily always have to use marabou. You can use Arctic fox or sheep, anything long, natural, that has good movement in the water, really undulates. That's the main ingredient in a good carp fly, is a good lifelike movement. I gotta get some sleep.